just having a safe, effective vaccine alone is not going to be enough. We also must make sure that it reaches people globally, that it's delivered with both immediate and long-term public health impact in mind, and crucially, that questions of fairness and equity are taken into consideration. What we want to avoid is a scenario, unfortunately one that's already happening, a scenario in which rich countries essentially buy up the whole vaccine supply and poor countries are left behind.
What we're seeing right now is that the countries that have the high-income countries with strong economic power are competing with themselves to gain access to vaccines for their own populations. And so lower middle-income countries without the finances to play in those markets are left out of that game. So what we're trying to do with this project is to A, understand the issues at play in equitable distribution, allocation of vaccines. And with the second one, to think through what it means to be able to distribute and deliver these vaccines to the populations around the world.
So we have a potential problem on our hands. We have rich countries that are entering into these bilateral deals with vaccine companies, manufacturers of COVID-19 vaccines, and the poor world could get left behind. Now, there is a new initiative called the COVAX facility that is trying to address this problem. It involves three actors. GAVI, the Vaccine Alliance, a Geneva-based institution that buys vaccines for low-income and lower middle-income countries. CEPI, a Norway-based organization, a product development partnership that is developing COVID-19 vaccines, and the World Health Organization. Our study, we hope, is going to strengthen COVAX facility's hand and help that facility ensure that more people in low income and lower middle income countries get vaccines. And what I think is interesting and innovative about this study is that it uses a kind of approach called game theory analysis to game out what some of those incentives might be. So are there ways in which we can change the rules of the game in order that high-income countries are more likely to participate in COVAX? That is what we are doing. Because we want the results of this to actually have an impact, to actually be valuable to the decision-making process right now. If there are incentives, for example, that COVAX hadn't thought about, that it could potentially offer, we wanted to present those results now.
So there's an assumption that if vaccines are available today, that they will get to everyone, but that's not necessarily true. Because we know that in many low and middle income countries around the world, we've had regular vaccines available, and yet immunization rates among children under five are still very, very low in some regions, and especially among places in the world that have high proportions of poverty. So in this case, what we're trying to see is what are the necessary systems that need to be put in place, what finances are necessary in low and middle income countries around the world, what are the bottlenecks that low and middle income countries are facing that need to be addressed for vaccines that are produced, or whatever successful vaccine, COVID-19 vaccine comes available, so that it gets to the ultimate beneficiaries. The reason why equity and access to vaccines is important, first of all, from a pandemic, in a pandemic, right, because it's an infectious disease, until everyone is safe, no one is safe, right? So as long as there are hotspots around the world, there is potential for transmission to other parts. Investments in health system strengthening take time to materialize. So it's impossible to invest in building a system and capture the gains immediately. So if we're hoping to make vaccines accessible to people who need them, then it's important to start the investments now. And you only start the investments now when you know how much you need to invest, you know where you need to invest them, and you also have an idea of the potential returns from those investments. So while there's a time lag for vaccine development, there's also a time lag, and you need to capture the benefits of health system strengthening. And so investments need to start early. Yes, we really hope the impact of this work will go beyond just COVID-19 vaccines. What we hope will happen is that this is an opportunity to build a health system, and that the strength of this new health system that is built, right, will translate into other areas of health beyond just COVID-19.